Right, so time to get into the serious stuff now. First of all, the molecular formula of MAC. So cannot your atoms, see what you get up with. So you've got 4 carbon, 7 hydrogens, and a chlorine. So C4H7Cl. Draw the skeletal formula of MAC. Well, you've got your double bond there. Then you've got your methyl group there. Then you've got your CH2 group there. And then you've got your Cl. MAC has several structural isomers. What I meant by structural isomer? A structural isomer combines with the same molecular formula, but a different structural formula. MAC is highly flammable. When it burns, a toxic gas is formed. Okay, we probably could guess what it's going to be, but we're going to have to work this one out. So you need to use the ideal gas equation for this. So it's giving me a mass, and then I can find the number of moles from this. So N, as you know, equals PV over RT. Convert everything to the right units. You've got 100 times 10 to the 3 for your pressure, because you need to convert that into pascals. Your volume you need to convert into meters. So that's times 10 to the minus 3. Do all of that. And then you've got 8.314 for R. Your temperature, they've given to you already in Kelvin. You do that, that comes to 0.0362 mole. Right, and then you divide that number by that number, because MR equals mass over moles, and that comes to, whoopsie daisy, that comes to 36.5 grams per mole, which looks like it's gonna be HCl. So the answer is HCl. Okay, so flowchart shows some reactions below. We need to give the product of reaction one and the structure of the mine organic for reaction two. Okay, so I'm using hydrogen with nickel, so I'm going to add hydrogen across that double bond. So it puts hydrogen there, carbon. Let's put my hydrogen there, CH3 there, and CH2Cl there. Just added hydrogen across that double bond. This is the major product, because I'm adding HCl across there. As you know, H, the major one will be H goes there, the Cl goes there, because the H joins the carbon with the most hydrogens. So the minor product will just be where I swap those over. So we do this one, CH2Cl, and that's going to be H, that will be H there. But now this will be Cl there, and then my other H will go there. Okay, so now once we do the mechanism, so let's give a go at this. So I've got my double bond here. Let's put my CH3 there, and I'll put CH2Cl there, and then in comes my HCl there. That's delta plus, that's going to be delta negative. The double bond will break, and I will add across that carbon there, which means that needs to break there to give me HCH. I've added my H there. And then I've got my carbocation, which is, of course, a tertiary carbocation, so it's nice and stable. And then I've got Cl minus, remember, stick on your lone pair, and then that adds like so. Okay, so explain why compound B is a minor product. Well, it's because the intermediate carbocation is less stable, because in the one that we've just done, you formed a tertiary carbocation, which is much more stable than a primary carbocation. MAC reacts with water in the presence of silver nitrate and ethanol. Draw the structure of the product. Well, what will happen is that I will lose, if we just whiz back to MAC, there we go. This won't be affected by it, but this CH2 will become CH2OH. I'll have a nucleophilic substitution reaction from there. What would I observe? Well, if I've got silver nitrate, this chloride ion comes off like that, so I'll form silver chloride, so I will see a white precipitate. Okay, so now I need to identify compound C. So let's first of all work out the molecular formula, or the empirical formula. It's given me the percentage composition by mass. So, should be able to do it twice. So, C is 46.1, H is 7.7, and O is 46.2. Divided by the relative atomic mass of each, that becomes 3.84, 7.7, and 2.89. Divide by the smallest one, and I get that ratio. Obviously, I need to times all of these by 3 to give whole numbers. So I get 3.84. So the molecular formula is C4H8O3. Notice I haven't got any chlorides there. So all the chlorides are gone. Now let's look at my infrared. I have got quite clearly C double bond O there. I have also got OH there, but I've also got this OH associated with carboxylic acid here because it's so broad. So it looks like I've got an alcohol and I've also got a carboxylic acid. So it looks like what I've got is CCHHH. And then I replace one there, that becomes CH3, and then that becomes my carboxylic acid. Why can't this OH become a carboxylic acid? Well, if you look at it, this is going to be, well, this is actually a tertiary alcohol, isn't it? So it can't be oxidized. Whereas this one, if we go here, so that became an OH, and then that became an OH, this group, this OH was then a primary alcohol, which can be oxidized. This one, with your C there, C there, and C there, is a tertiary alcohol, so it cannot be oxidized.